Today we're combining a few simple elements into holiday ornaments. Felt balls, acorn caps, faux snow, and glitter. We'll use them all to create these pretty little decorations. The first step to making these acorn ornaments is to attach some sort of a hanger to the top. Now for the ones that you see here, I have chosen to use, this is actually DMC Metallic Pearl Cotton, and it's silver, and I've chosen to use that because that kind of fits in with my theme. A little bit later on, I'll show you a different way that you can put a hanger on. This is a little bit blingy, which really goes with the whole Snowtex and glitter theme. But if you want something that's a little bit more natural, a little bit less blingy, I'm going to show you another option for that later. So I'm starting with a length of the metallic floss, and all I'm going to do is tie an overhand knot, and I'm going to make the hanging loop. I'm probably not going to use a hanger like the traditional ones that you would use on a Christmas tree, those wire loops. I kind of like this look better. So again, I've got my loop made here, and I'm going to trim the excess off of this knot. And I'm going to trim it pretty close because I don't want to deal with any bulk or anything when I go to attach this. And these are basically all done the same way. I'm going to use some of my super duper thick Aliens tacky glue here. I'm going to get a blob of glue kind of on the end of my toothpick, and I'm going to get a blob of glue on that acorn cap to start with. And then I'm going to grab another toothpick, and I'm actually going to use it to push the knot and bury it down in that glue. Now, the easiest way to do this is to let this do what it basically just did, which was it kind of falls off to the side like that. But sometimes when the hanging loop is horizontal like this, and I can't pick this up now because the glue hasn't set yet, but when you pick this up, it's not going to hang straight. And if that's the case, I don't know about you, but those are the kind of things that make me just a little bit crazy. Here are some others that I did about an hour ago, and the glue has skinned over, and it's already started to set up a little bit. Now again, this one's kind of laying off to the side. Because this glue has started to set, I can lift this up and kind of manipulate that little puddle of glue till I get this standing up more or less straight, and I can play with this until I can pick this cap up and it hangs more or less straight. It's never going to be perfect, but when you're playing with these, I kind of like the idea that this is going to hang off the tree and it's only going to tip a little bit. I don't want it looking, you know, like this when it hangs, because that again will make me a little bit crazy. So once you get your glue on, you can either let it set up a little bit and then, as I said, you can adjust your hanging loops, or you can just come right in and get on with the next step, which is the Snowtex. Now if you're going to use Snowtex, you can sort of pile on within maybe 15 or 20 minutes of, you know, getting your hanger in place. If you're going to use the second method that I'm going to show you, which is to use some Lumiere, this is their pearlescent white paint, and I've done basically the same thing with the glitters, but because I use the white paint, you don't have the dimension that you get when you use the Snowtex, where you can kind of pile this up to get more of a mounded snow look. If you're going to go with the Lumiere, you probably are going to need to let this glue sit for a good hour so that you know that that's set and skinned over and it's not going to get mixed in with the paint. That's what we're going to do next. We're going to look at getting either Snowtex or Lumiere on here, and then the options for glittering the tops. If you want that kind of mounded up snowy look, Snowtex is really the way to get that. And it's just a matter of applying it on top of your acorn top and then deciding if you want to leave it alone or if you want to add a little bit of glimmer to it. And I ended up using three different options for the glimmer and glitter on top of my Snowtex. I'm using R Sparkling Snow Glitter, I'm using Diamond Dust, and I'm actually using Tim's new Clear Rock Candy Glitter. And I played with various combinations, some with one, some without one, and ultimately I decided I kind of like the look best when I use all three. The Diamond Dust is far larger particles than Tim's Distress Rock Candy Glitter, and neither of them have any real glimmer to them. They're both just clear colors. So I brought in our Sparkling Snow, and that's what's going to give this the iridescent glittery look. So it kind of depends on what you're looking for, but I really do like the combination of the three. I think it makes a really fun look. So you're going to start with the Snowtex, and I'm using a palette knife for this. I find it easier to do this way. I'm just going to pick up a little bit of the Snowtex, and you're going to apply it to the top of the acorn cap. Now obviously snow, when it falls on things, is not perfectly neat and straight, and so you don't have to spend a lot of time worrying about how you're applying the Snotex. It's really just making certain that you bury the area where your hanging loop is, and then just putting on as much or as little as you like. Again, really straightforward. Just kind of slap the Snotex on there. This is not rocket science. Now when I do this, I mostly just sort of leave it on the top. I don't bring it all the way around the sides of the acorn cap, though you could do that if you wanted to. Okay, let me just get this back in the jar. Put this to one side. So once you get this done, then in comes the glitter. So here's Tim's Distress Rock Clear Rock Candy. Here is Diamond Dust. And here is our Joggles Sparkling Snow. And again, this is where you're going to get the colorful glimmer, because this is a multicolored glitter, whereas both of these, whether it's large particles or smaller ones, have no color to them. So what I like to do is I like to start with Tim's glitter, and I'm just going to come and I'm going to apply some to the top of the sparkling snow, and all I'm just going to do is tap it in there, and then I'm going to come back to the diamond dust, and then lastly I'm going to roll it in our Joggles sparkling snow glitter, and you get this effect. Now if you just want to go with, for example, the new rock candy glitter, then all you have to do is just drop this in here and put it on. Now it does kind of mush this sort of snowfall effect when you put it in the glitter, so if you want to come back and just sort of change the shape a little bit and then come back and dunk it again, and if you don't press real hard you won't really alter sort of that ambiguous, not smushed down look. And really that's all there is to this. If you decide that you want to use Lumiere paint instead, that's very straightforward too. Let me just move this stuff off to one side for a moment. And when you're working with the Snotex, if you're working on a palette knife, be sure to clean it off, because if it dries on that palette knife, you'll end up having to sand it off. So again, here comes some. This is Lumiere Pearl White. Just going to grab a regular old brush. And I'm just going to pick up stuff from the cover. I don't need all that much, and I'm just going to dab it on here kind of randomly. Again, there's not a whole lot of rhyme or reason to what I'm doing. I just want to get some color on here, and I want to put something on there that's wet, that the glitter, whichever one I end up using, has something to adhere to. So for this one, I'll probably use a combination of Tim's Clear Rock Candy and our Joggles Sparkling Snow, just again because I do want some color in there as well. Again, super easy. So again, I like to work in assembly line fashion. I'll come along and I'll do a bunch of tops, get them to this point, and then let them dry. And once they're dry, we can actually think about attaching the wool felt balls to them to make our hanging acorn ornaments. So here I go. I have a bunch of my acorn caps all prepped. They're all dry. They're ready to go. It's now just a question of assembling them with the felt balls. These are 1.5 centimeter felt balls, and I found that this was the size that fit best with this group of acorn caps that I have. And they range in size. Obviously, the way things are made in nature, you're not going to get two acorn caps that are the exact same size. And because these felt balls are handmade, they're going to vary a little bit too. But 1.5 centimeters is a pretty good rough guess on what these sizes are. So putting these together is really simple. I'm just going to, again, here comes my super favorite glue. I'm not a big hot glue fan. Even the Cool Melt ones, I find I make even more of a mess with than normal. I will confess to being a very bad gluer. I'm messy, the whole nine yards. So I do use this. I find that I get the best results with it. It's very thick, so things really stick to it immediately. Now, this is way too much glue in this cap, so I'm going to take some of this out, because what I don't want this to do is ooze out the sides. I mean, it does dry clear, so obviously that's kind of a saving grace, but I don't want this to just sort of be gushed out all around the top edges of that felt ball. So that's pretty much enough glue. I'm going to grab a ball, and I'm going to push it in there. Now, I did get a little bit leak out right there, so I can do two things. I can either try to take that off, or what I can do is bring in some glitter and just go ahead and stick this in the glitter and let it adhere to that little bit of glue. Let me get that back out. And now what I just have is some glitter that kind of slipped off the top edge of my acorn cone, my acorn cap, and it's fine. Now obviously, because this glue is really thick and really heavy, this is going to hold this almost immediately, but it's going to take a few hours to dry because there's a fair amount of glue in there. So really, you just, as I said, I like to kind of work in assembly line fashion. All you're going to do is put the glue inside your acorn cap and then just get that acorn shoved in there, put it to one side, and let it dry. Now, one thing that you may find, again, because these things tend to be pretty variable, whoops, I now have glue on my finger. Again, I am perhaps the worst gluer in the world. But once you get these in there, you let them dry. Now, this is a fairly small acorn cap, and I could kind of cherry pick through my felt balls and try to find a small one, and I have done that. But here's something that works even better. Pick up one of the balls, and you can feel that they're fairly squishy, so what you can do is put it between your hands and roll it, and you can actually change the shape. I mean, this has become very egg-like. Now, that's a little bit too pointy for my taste, but what I'm trying to do is change the top, change one edge of this so that it fits into this acorn cap. I mean, you can sort of see the difference, the way that this kind of overfills that cap versus the one that I rolled, and it fits in there a little bit differently. And acorns are shaped various ways. Sometimes they're a little bit more elongated like this. Sometimes they're a little bit more round like this. It's nature. We can pretty much, you know, imitate that however we want. So don't forget that if you have a really small acorn cap, just put this between your hands, roll it back and forth a few times, whoops, change the shape, and then go ahead and glue this in place as I did a moment ago. Now, this particular style is fairly blingy. I mean, Christmas is really about bling and glimmer and glitter, at least in my world it is. So that's great. But if you decide that you want something a little bit more rustic looking, a little bit more natural looking, there's another way to achieve that. Let me get these out of the way. Let's get the glitter off of my work table as much as possible. And let me bring in these more rustic looking ones. These are ones that I did, and I worked again with 1.5 centimeter wool felt balls, but I've worked with them in such a way that you can make them look very realistic without all of the glitter and all of the bling if your preference is not to have them. I used black pearl cotton here, and you'll notice that there's nothing mounded up on the top of any of these, and I'm going to show you how to put these together in just a second. If you want a little bit of glimmer, you can use your metallic DMC pearl cotton like we did with these here so that you get just a little bit of glimmer. Or for something, again, that's very quite rustic looking, the black DMC pearl cotton, this is size 8, works really well. So how do you get this done without having to sort of pile on that mound of glue to get this end buried? And let me show you how I did that. I'm going to bring in just an acorn cap, and this is kind of a really heavy awl that I've had for a million years. If you very patiently, just ever so lightly, begin to bore with your awl through the top, you'll begin to make a hole, and you have to use very light pressure, or you'll actually split the acorn cap, but you can just kind of spend a couple of minutes and do this, and then once you do, you'll begin to see this pop through on the other side. And I can take my awl and I can kind of open this hole up from the back side. And there's the hole. You can see it in there right now. I have a piece of size 8 pearl cotton. And depending on what size your hole is, you might be able to fit the knot through. But if you can't, all you have to do is, and I'm not going to be able to do this because this hole isn't quite big enough. I have to bore this just a little bit bigger. All you have to do is take your end without the knot, sort of fold it in half, and then just feed it through this opening. Now you might need to use a toothpick to kind of push it through. And there it comes. Now don't pull too hard, because unless you've made a really big knot, you'll end up pulling this all the way through. But the way to get that set in place is to just go ahead and pull it almost all the way through, and then get some glue in there. And that's what's going to hold this knot in place. Oops, now I have glue everywhere. There, let me just wipe my fingers. So now I have this knot in place, and it might not be a bad idea to just put this to one side and let this set up, but if you're impatient, and God knows I'm impatient, but if you are, you can just take, and again, I came back and I used these kind of rustic looking colors. I mean, in the multi-mix packs, there are really bright colors, so if you wanted to make some bright looking acorns, you could do that, but I'm kind of keeping to that little bit quieter, quainter, rustic look, and I'm pretty certain that this will fit, though I might elongate it just a little bit, and then I'll come in with some more glue. See if I can do this without getting glue everywhere. I'll come in with some more glue, and it's basically the same process that we did a moment ago with the glitter topped ones. You're just going to push that in there and then put it to one side and let it dry. But you get a real quaint look like this. So you have options. You can do bling, or you can do a little bit more quaint. Once the glue that's holding the wool felt ball into that acorn cap has dried, you can begin to think about how you might like to embellish your ornaments. You can leave them alone so that they just hang on the tree, kind of looking like this, and that's really nice. I like that look. You can do some other things as well. This has got some glitter on it, I've embroidered a face, and I've just put some beads on here. Now this is really straightforward. All you have to do is take a little bit of any kind of glue that you have, and you want to water it down so it's very loose and water-like. And you're just going to, once you do it on the craft sheet, you're just going to pick it up with your finger and dab it on here in some places, and then you're just going to roll the ball in your glitter. Sometimes putting the glue on will lift the fibers a little bit. Once this is dry, just come back with some scissors, and if you've got any fibers sticking off the surface, you can trim them. That's real easy. Putting the face on here is not difficult at all. I'm going to use one of these disappearing markers, and I'm just going to mark the facial features. Now, what I want to do is figure out how this is going to be turned when it is hung on a branch. And I can see that my loop is lined up here, so I know that either this side or the opposite side will face outward when I put this on a branch. It always drives me just a little bit crazy when I put an ornament on a branch and discover that once it gets through twisting and turning, the part that I want to see has disappeared to the back. So I'm just going to use this marker to lightly make some notations about where the facial features go, and you can see that's done. So I have some black pearl cotton. I've put a needle in the end, I've put a knot in the end, and I've trimmed off the tail so it's pretty close. All I'm going to do is come in from the back to this first eye, and I'm actually going to do X's like I've done here. So I don't want to come out in the middle of the dot. I want to come out to one side or the other so I can form that cross. And I'm just going to pull this through, and if you just grab a hold of the pearl cotton and give it a tug, that knot will disappear inside, and there, it's already popped in. So now all I'm going to do is just stitch my X. I want to keep this fairly small because this is a small ornament. I don't want this to get oversized and look too ungainly on there. Again, I'll just sort of come over here and make my other cross for the other eye. Once this is done, I know I want to come up in where the nose is going to be, so I'm just going to come right up there. And you can either do a French knot, you can just take a little stitch like I've done here, just to make a dot for the nose, and then it's just a question of sort of coming down, and actually I want to come down on this side, coming down to the edge of the mouth. And so there are my eyes and my nose. And now I'm just probably going to take a single stitch across. I'm not going to make the mouth as wide as I made the dot. Or excuse me, not the dot, the line. So I'm going to stitch, and then I'm just going to come probably back up in the middle. I'm going to put a little tacking stitch to hold that in place. So I'm just going to pull that up, and then it's just this little couching stitch that will hold my mouth in place. I'm going to feed the needle through the back of the ball. And you can see that once this pulls up, I've got that little mouth on there. I'm going to pull the needle through the back of the ball. I'm going to make a knot. fairly close to the surface of the ball. And then don't make a big knot. You're just going to want to loop this around once and you kind of pull it up so that that knot tightens up. And then you more or less go back through the same hole where you came out. Just come off to the side so you can pop that knot inside the ball. Then grab your scissors, trim flush with the surface of the ball. And if you manipulate that, that will just disappear under the surface. And there's the face. I mean, this is just simple and cute, and you can get as elaborate as you want. You could use little black beads for the eyes if you had those. Again, very straightforward. Now, speaking of beads, on this one, I hadn't done this before, but I decided to go ahead and just put some beads on one of these white acorns, and I like the look. I can do that again on any of these, and if I wanted to bring in some of my more rustic ones that we looked at earlier, I could probably bead on them, but I like these the way that they are. I'm not necessarily feeling the need to gussy them up at all, so I'll probably leave them alone. But the process for putting the beads on is the same whether you're working with just a ball like this or you're going to go ahead and do what I did here. So I'm going to work on a ball so that I can show you, sort of kill two birds with one stone. I'm going to show you how you can take just a plain ball and bead it, and again the process applies to the acorns as well. And then I'll show you how you can use some more of this DMC, this metallic pearl cotton, and we'll make a hanger. A little bit, it'll look very similar to this, but the process is a little bit different. This is, it's a beading mat, and basically what this does is it stops the beads from rolling all over the place, which can be incredibly frustrating when you're trying to bead. So I'm just going to knock a few of each of these color beads out onto this surface. Put this to one side. Now I'm working with gray selenite. It's kind of a neutral color. You could work with off-white. You're not going to see any of this, so it really, the color is kind of irrelevant. I have a knot here. I'm just going to trim the tail off, and I'm basically going to do the same thing now as I did a moment ago when I buried the knot. So I'm just going to pull the needle through. Now because this thread is far thinner than the pearl cotton, this is going to pull through very easily, so if you pull too hard, you're going to end up pulling it straight out of the ball. And what you can do is just take the tiniest little stitch right here where this thread is coming out of the ball, and that will help make certain that you don't pull that all the way through and you find that your thread is not even in the ball anymore. Then it's just a question of picking up a bead, taking a little stitch, going to the next spot, and you see that that fits in there and it just sits nice on the surface. And I'm going to just alternate these colors. They're not actually a lot of difference between the two colors. I could probably get away with just doing one of these if I wanted to, but I had them both out, so I figured I would just go ahead with that. And you can add beads to the surface as densely as you want. If you want a lot of beads, then go ahead and put a lot on. And if you don't, you just do less. So I'm just going to get these on the surface, and then I want to show you how to put the hanger on. And I'm just going to keep rotating around where the needle comes out to fill in open places on this ball. And again, this is one of the 1.5 centimeter balls. Let's see, kind of got an open spot over here. When you thread your needle, make certain that you take at least a 24-inch length of thread, and perhaps a little bit longer. You want it as long as it can be without being so long that it's going to tangle, because you're going to go back and forth here through here so many times that you're going to use a fair amount of thread and you don't want to run out. That's just aggravation to have to stop and start all over again. All right, so I'm looking at this, and I'm thinking this is probably pretty good. So all I'm going to do is come through. I'm going to make a little knot. Actually, you know what, before I do that, I'm going to take a little teeny stitch, just enough so that I won't be able to see it, and then I'm going to make a knot fairly close to the surface. Again, I'm just going to pull, go back through the hole where I came out, or as close to it as possible, and then I'm just going to pull that inside, and that way I've buried that knot and I won't see it. I'm going to cut the beading thread flush with the surface. Now this is a crewel needle, I believe. It has a big eye, which you need in order to be able to use this metallic floss, and it has a point on the end. So you can see that I've already gotten some unraveling going on here, but I have enough on that it's not going to make a difference. So I'm trying to find an open spot on here, and this actually looks pretty good where there aren't a lot of beads. And all I'm going to do, let me bring in the one that I did. You can see that I just made a stitch through there, pulled it through, and then I knotted the end. So again, I'm just going to sort of find my open spot. This looks pretty good. I'm going to go reasonably deep inside the ball, but I'm not going to take a very long stitch. Now it's important that you have a big bodied needle like this. You need that in order to make a hole big enough through this ball so that you can get this pearl cotton pulled through. Now I need to get this end pulled through. At this point, I'm going to take the needle out of the picture here because it's just in the way. I'm going to bring my ends together as long as I want this hanger to be, and I'm going to tie an overhand knot. I'm going to do basically the same thing that we did the last time when we made the hangers for the acorn caps. The only difference now is that the knot is actually going to be on the top, and it won't be buried underneath the glue and the Snowtex. Once I get this pulled good and tight, I'm going to come in and I want to trim this as close to the knot as I can get without actually cutting the knot, and then I'm going to bring in some fray check. This is going to allow me to cut those ends really close, and I can put this just a little tiny dab of this on here. It's clear, so I know you can't see it, but once that's dry, I know that that knot will never come undone, and I don't have to worry about the integrity of my little hanger. So again, these are kind of fun, whether you just want to do these by themselves or you want to go ahead and put some beads on your acorns here that are hanging. And then the other thing that I want to show you, and I don't have them nearby, we're going to take some 1.5 centimeter balls and then some 2 centimeter balls, and we're going to put them together and we're going to use some beads in a different way to make a different kind of hanging ornament. There are lots of ways to make ornaments with the felt balls in addition to using them to make our acorns, and I'm going to show you a couple of different things here. Now obviously a moment ago we took a look at just going ahead and beading, and this is the 1.5 centimeter ball. You could certainly do that on the 2-inch size, excuse me, the 2 centimeter size too if you want. You can also combine them. Here I've put the larger one on top and the 1.5 centimeter on the bottom, and I've strung them with some beads. On this one I did just the opposite. I put the larger one on the bottom and then the other one on top. Again, these are both 2 centimeters and 1.5. It's just a question of how you arrange them. I'm going to show you very simply what I did to make these. Again, I have my needle with some gray silamide. I put a knot in the end. And what I'm going to do is just, I think we'll start with the small one. I think I'll put the bigger one on the top and the smaller one on the bottom. So I'm just going to go ahead and pull this through the way that we did the last time. And I'm going to take one little tiny stitch just to be certain that I don't pull that out. Never going to see it in the felt ball, so I'm really not worried about it. All right, so if I imagine this to be the bottom of the ball where this business right here is going to be coming out, what I need to do, and this time I think I'm going to do sort of what I did here, I'm going to use a sequin too, which I think is fun. So I'm going to take one of these sequins, and these are 5 millimeter, and they're very slightly cup shaped, and I want the cup to go out and up off the bottom, so I'm going to feed it along the thread like this, and now this is the bottom of my ball. So what I need to do is just put a couple of beads on here, and I'm going to basically mimic what I did here, which is just a couple of 11-0 seed beads. This is a 6 millimeter fire polish, and then I use another 11-0 seed bead as a stop bead. So let me just grab a couple of these. Let me move this so you can see what I'm doing. Grab a couple of these 11-0 seed beads and my fire polish bead. This is a 6 millimeter. You could use 4s if you wanted. But whatever, they both work. It's just a matter of looking at your scale. So this is what I have so far. I need to pick up a stop bead. And what I'm going to do now is I'm going to run the needle back up through this length, but I am not going to run it through the stop bead. The whole point of this bead is that it's going to stop everything from slipping down. So let me just bring this in here. Here's my stop bead. Right here. And here's my bead grouping. So with my stop bead out of the way, I'm going to take my needle and I'm going to run it, and I need to turn this toward me. I'm going to run this through the grouping of beads. and I want to be certain that it goes through all of the beads and this sequin, and that I don't miss. Now what I want to do is come straight up through the top, if at all possible, so that I'm making a vertical run right up through the top here. And if I'm off a little bit, which I can see that I am, I can kind of back the needle out a little bit and I can sort of rearrange the path. And I'm pushing on the bottom of the needle and pushing everything through, because this is not a really long needle. I have to kind of work to get it through the height of the ball. So now what I have is, here's my stop bead on the end and my grouping, and I just need to pull this up and pull up the excess thread so that I get this little dangly bit at the bottom. And you have to be careful. You don't want to pull too tight, because this gets kind of rigid and it's not terribly graceful the way that it drapes. But you also don't want to leave a big gap in there, because you don't want to see any separation between the sequin and the bottom of the ball, or between any of the beads. So now that I'm basically coming out the top of my ball, what I'm going to do is feed another sequin on here. All right, and then I'm just going to pick up a few beads, and I'll probably just alternate my colors here, and then use another one of the 6mm fire polished, and then alternate my colors again. Oops. And feed these down through, and you can see I've got my middle section done. So what I need now is another sequin to complete that sequence. Put that down in place. All right, so there's that part, and here's my, this is now a 2cm ball. And again, I'm going to feed the needle through, and I want to come as straight up through as possible. And I'm just kind of looking around and looking down to see if I look like I'm pretty much coming out centered, and that looks good. So I'm going to pull this up. And now you can see I have the bulk of this done. At this point, what I'm going to do is, I could put another bead on the top here if I wanted, but if I sort of follow the path of what I did here, at this point it's just a question of, and let me just bring some beads in here, it's just a question of picking up beads and beading them in place, much the same way, or stitching them in place, much the same way as we did here. And I'll do that all around this top bead, and then I'll have my top bead so that it looks like this. And then I can end my thread the way that I showed you a few moments ago, and then I'll do the same thing down here on the bottom, so I have, you know, beads on both of these balls. And then the process would be the same as I showed you a few minutes ago, where you'll take your big embroidery needle with your metallic floss, and you're just going to make that hanger on the top here. You can see that these are basically the same thing. I've just put two together here. So as long as you can do what we did a few minutes ago, you can certainly finish this up. Now the one other thing that I did want to show you, and let me just kind of clear this out of the way, is this ball here. This is a 2cm ball, and what I did was I put some single 11-0 seed beads on it, and you can see those here, but I also worked with a sequin, an 8-0 bead with an 11-0 bead sitting on top as a stop bead, and I just quickly want to show you that, and then we'll actually call ourselves done for today. So I'm going to throw a few of those out there. And of course I don't have a needle ready. That was really poor planning on my part, so bear with me one second. I need to find a needle, and I need to get it threaded. Okay, I'm back. I have another needle threaded now, and basically I'm going to do the same thing you've seen me do each time when we've started one of these. I've got a knot in my thread. I'm just going to lightly pull that through to bury the knot inside. I'm going to take that little teeny stitch just to make certain that that doesn't pull out on me. And on this, that stitch could actually show it's not going to make any difference, because I'm going to use one of these 5mm sequins, and again, I'm going to work with it so that it's, the cup is facing upward. Let's see if I can turn that so you can see it. See how the cup is facing up? I want it that way against the bead. I'm going to move this all the way down, and then I'm going to pick up one of my 8mm beads. I'm going to slide that all the way down to the top two, or to the bottom rather. And then I'm going to pick up one of my stopper beads. And what did I do with the color that I wanted to use? Well, it doesn't matter. I'll just use one of these. And I'm going to do the same thing that I did a moment ago, where I'm going to feed this back through, but I'm obviously not going to feed it through the stopper bead. So I'll go through this 8-0, through the sequin, and then I'll just come out another spot where I know that I can put another grouping of beads like this. And then if you just give this a little tug, the nice thing about using an 11-0 with an 8-0 is that the 11-0 pretty much stands up right inside that opening, if you will. It will fit right inside the opening right here, and it kind of sits up very nicely, and so you get this real dimensional look. And you'll just do that all the way around your bead. Go ahead and use the metallic pearl cotton to make a hanger as we did in the past, and then you'll be done. These kind of remind me of alien spaceships, but I think that they're fun. If you have a kid's tree or you just want a little whimsy, I think any or all of these are a really good choice. Whether you choose to use the acorn tops or you don't, whether you choose to go with bling or you want to go a little bit more rustic and natural, there's really just so many options. Lots and lots of fun things that you can do with these wool felt beads, some acorn caps, and a little bit of thyme.